Wonder Woman 1984 is once again directed by Patty Jenkins and is the first Warner Brothers film to be released on HBO Max and theaters in this huge move that they did. Rewind to the 1980s as Wonder Woman's next big screen adventure finds herself facing two all-new foes, Max Lord and the Cheetah. I had to read that description of the plot right off of IMDb just because I don't know what I can really say with spoilers. This is going to be extremely difficult to review without spoilers because I've only seen one trailer. I don't know what the other trailer showed. I don't want to spoil something for you guys if you haven't seen it and you really want to see this movie. But this movie should be renamed Wonder Woman Clusterfuck. I was very disappointed in Wonder Woman 1984 because I really enjoyed the first Wonder Woman movie. It was the best DC Expanded Universe movie they've made so far. So I was excited to hear for the sequel, Patty Jenkins would be back, and that it was taking place in like the 80s. Like, ooh, that's new and different. And after watching this movie, there are so many things that had me scratching my head. First, I'll talk about what I liked about this film. I think Patty Jenkins did do a good job directing this movie. I think it looks very colorful. I really love the colors in this movie, and it looks good. And I think the performances all around are really great. Gal Gadot is great as Wonder Woman. I always love seeing her playing the character. Chris Pine was a lot of fun. I think Pedro Pascal did a great job playing this villain. And I think Kristen Wiig did a great job as well, doing something different than comedy. I also like Kristen Wiig's character. I thought that was the most interesting character in this whole movie. I thought her motivations and reasons why she does things throughout the movie made the most sense, made her the most interesting character. Even though her lines can be a little cheesy, but that has nothing to do with Kristen Wiig's performance. I wish she was in the movie more, honestly. And let's get into my issues now, because I have a lot of issues with Wonder Woman 1984. Like I just said, I wish Kristen Wiig was in the movie a lot more, because I felt like her character was more interesting and had clearer motivations than Pedro Pascal's character. I thought Pedro Pascal did a great job with his performance, but his character has a motivation that is very clear in the first act of this movie. And then as time goes on, the motivation and his goal become less and less clear, and you ask yourself, what is he even trying to accomplish? By the end of the movie, I don't even know what the fuck he's trying to do. It's just a giant mess. I don't know what his endgame is. Part of his motivation has a plot device that's in this movie that I can't say because it'd be a spoiler, that is a plot device that if you put in any other movie, not just this one, any other movie, there will be plot holes and there'll be loopholes and it could possibly make your movie a mess. So it's really risky to put this plot device in the movie. And once this plot device is placed in this movie and it's used throughout the movie with different characters, things start to get kind of confusing and really messy. Man, it's really hard to talk about this without spoiling it because he starts doing things and starts using other characters and man, it's hard to talk about this without spoiling it. It's really hard. It just didn't really make sense to me. A lot of things that he was trying to do in this movie. Like I said, in the first act, it was pretty clear what he was trying to accomplish. But then after that, I just was lost. This movie is also way too long. This movie is 2.5 hours long. This movie is so long. It didn't need to be this long. And because this movie's so long, there are parts where this movie just drags completely. Especially in the first act of this movie. The first half of this movie, honestly. There was definitely a lot of things in this first act of this movie that you could have shaved off to make this runtime not so long. I mean, 2.5 hours is a long fucking time. There are some interesting ideas and themes in this film somewhere in this mess. Which makes me think they could have probably thought of a pretty good movie. But they just didn't. I don't understand some of the decisions they made with some of our characters, with the plot. Overall, it just felt like a mess. By the last act of this movie, I understood what Wonder Woman was trying to stop, but I didn't understand what our villains were trying to accomplish, if that makes sense. This film suffers heavily from sequelitis. They feel like they have to top everything from the first one, make the stakes bigger, do everything bigger. But the thing that made the first film so great is it felt like it was this grounded adventure, like this smaller scale adventure compared to like Man of Steel or Dawn of Justice where cities are just getting fucking leveled. Wonder Woman felt like it was a smaller scale thing, even though the main threat was this larger than life thing that was probably going to end the world. The whole movie itself, though, didn't feel like it was part of this DC universe. It felt like its own really clever superhero movie. Now, with Wonder Woman 1984, I don't think it gets that level of destruction and just mayhem as Man of Steel or Dawn of Justice, but you could tell the filmmakers were like, we gotta do something bigger, guys. It's the second one. It has to be bigger. If it's not bigger, it's gonna be worse. No, you didn't have to do that. Especially with this plot device and the themes that they throw out in this movie, I feel like this movie could have been better if everything felt smaller scale. Everything felt more personable. You could tell the studio wanted to do something bigger, higher stakes, but it just doesn't work here. Some of the CGI here doesn't look great. They throw things in here that create plot holes for later films in the timeline, like Justice League and Dawn of Justice. I don't know. This movie just feels like a big step back from the original Wonder Woman. I get that you want to have large-scale shit happen in your superhero movie, but I feel like you should wait till the Justice League movie, like Justice League 2, instead of a Wonder Woman movie, because like I said, what made Wonder Woman so great was it felt like it was this smaller adventure focus more on the characters, because the characters are interesting. And because they tried to go larger scale here, it felt like the Wonder Woman franchise kind of took a step back. I'll be fair here, and I'll say that I thought the villains in Wonder Woman 1984 were more interesting than they were in the first Wonder Woman movie, but in the first Wonder Woman movie, I felt like his motivation was way more clear than Pedro Pascal's character, so that kind of cancels out. But Christian Wiig's character, I thought, was way more interesting than all of them. So I gotta give him a compliment there, but like I said, everything else just felt like a step backwards from Wonder Woman, which is such a shame because that's my favorite movie in the DC universe. In the end though, Wonder Woman 1984 was a huge disappointment for me. I was really excited for this film because Patty Jenkins was returning and I really enjoyed the first Wonder Woman, but this movie is a huge mess. The performances are great and I really like Christian Wiig's character, and there's some themes that they throw in there that could have been really interesting, but if the movie was more focused, then the film could have been overall better. The movie's a mess. Some motivations are completely unclear, it's way too long, the pacing is off, and it just felt like a huge step back for Wonder Woman and the DC Universe. I'm going to give Wonder Woman 1984 5.5 Davy Daves. There's a scene in here that was really emotional that I really liked, but then they started playing a song from the X-Men Days of Future Past trailer that I've heard a million times. I'm like, we have Hans Zimmer. Why can't he just make a new score for this scene? This is a great scene. It just felt lazy. Like I said, everything just felt like they took a step back from what they did with the first film. Disappointing. Because I actually was looking forward to this. Even though I don't really like the DCU that much, or the DC expanded universe, I don't really like it that much, but I was actually looking forward to Wonder Woman 1984. So, Wonder Woman 1984. Let me know what you guys thought of it if you've seen it. Thank you so much for watching. Click here to see more Davy Dave's Takes.